Ghana, and welcome to another edition of Eye on Ports. It's a program we have designed to bring the activities of the ports of Ghana closer to you, and also you closer to the ports of Ghana. The program is brought to you by the kind courtesy of Star Assurance. Star Assurance, they are your solid partner as far as business is concerned. If you're doing business in the marine industry, the best insurance company for you is Star Assurance, your solid partner. And also UT Logistics. UT Logistics, if you're in the logistics business, UT Logistics is your choice because they offer you a customized solution. In today's edition, we're going to be talking about the expansion work that's going to take place at the Port of Tema. We'll also talk about some of the challenges within the Port of Tema. The Director of Port is going to speak to us about what's going to be done about those challenges and whether indeed those challenges are anything to go by.
Is the port congested?
Currently, the ports, by our standard, will not be said to be congested because we have introduced measures to forestall the capacity problem. We had a capacity challenge in the past where cargo cannot be stored in the port for a very long time, and we have introduced measures to improve efficiency in the port. So as we improve efficiency, space became available, so congestion levels have reduced. But currently, what is necessary now is to go deeper and then to extend the port to take advantage of economies of scale. And that is what the port is now trying to address by just moving away from the current status of trying to improve the facilities in the existing port. We introduce some 3 mobile harbor cranes into the port, the cost ranging, getting up to 7.5 million euros. That was what we introduced last year. And with that one, with the limited dredging we did, it added value to the general cargo area of the port. If I can tell you now that container vessel owners will want their vessels not to queue at the anchorage again, waiting for MPS terminal or the container terminal at MPS, but rather prefer to come to GPHA terminal to work faster with our harbor mobile crane and then leave so that other vessels can come in. You'll be surprised.
I see. So it means that the GPHA terminal is working very fast.
Very, very fast. To give you a clear indication, since the beginning of this year, the berth, that area, had seen a tremendous improvement in container handling activities. Every month we handle more than 8 container vessels at that terminal.
And this is because
of the new harbor mobile cranes that we have introduced, because of the logistics efficiency levels that we have introduced, we have trained our operators and they can move containers as fast as what is done at the container terminal. And for that reason, that's increased efficiency. The waiting time for vessels have reduced considerably. For example, last year, the previous 2013, the waiting time for vessels was as much as 7 days. But as we are speaking now, vessels do no longer wait at the anchorage, especially when they are coming into GPHA operated areas. We have berths available for them on arrival. From the beginning of this year to now, the first quarter,
it's no longer there. As soon as they come to anchorage, they are coming to the port. Wow,
yes.
That's good news. And how has that helped? How has that impacted on revenue generations, the ports improvement, and all of that?
In actual fact, it has impacted greatly on revenue generations. Why? Because vessels do not wait any longer at the anchorage. They come in and discharge and go. Cost of doing business in the port reduced considerably. But whether it will reflect on the freight ship owners will charge, that is left for the ship owner. But for us, what actually we're trying to do is, as the vessels stay in our port and work efficiently and go, it means that the cost of handling the vessel in the port will reduce, and that will be profit for the ship owner. And we believe that should impact on the freight charges the ship owners or the shipping agents charge on consumers.
Okay. Okay.
That is it. Our aim is to reduce the cost of doing business in the port, and we are online to achieve that.
Okay. An importer who was expecting a lot of things, a lot of goods coming in, and I used to be given the excuse that, your ship is in, but it's sitting on the sea. It hasn't come to the port now, and that is why your thing is delaying. Today, what will you say to that importer?
I will tell the importer that it should get back to the shipping line and collect the actual information, because GPHA never allow vessels to stay at the anchorage any longer. If they arrive, they come in the port, they work, and they sail. And we also make sure that the containers, when they are discharged, they are evacuated to the various terminals overnight, so that any importer who is ready to take his cargo or her cargo submit his documents. Well, finished with customs documentation, and when the documents are given to us, we make sure that we position the container, and then the next day when you come, the container is ready for you to take.
How long does it take for my container to be discharged from a vessel that has already arrived in your port?
If a container is on a vessel which has arrived in a port, depending upon the volume of container on a vessel, within 24 hours that container should be dropped onto our stacking area. The delay in clearing comes from one, the consignees themselves. After they have even had the information that the container is in the port, duty and documentation actually accounts for the delay they face. Now, after paying the duty, they have to go to a shipping line and get a release. Getting the release from the shipping line also can cause great delays to them.
Why?
Because they have to pay money to the shipping line. And if you don't have that money to pay to the shipping line, then you have to. And as you are waiting to pay the demurrage or the charges to the shipping line, and the container is sitting in the port, and it goes beyond 7 days, it means you have to pay rent to the port authority too. That is where the challenge is. First, before you even ship your goods, you know some of these goods need to go to customs regime. You need to pay duty. If you're not ready to pay duty, then I will advise you, don't put the cargo in a container and put on a ship to come to Ghana. But if you know that you're going to pay duty, make your duty available before you start importing. And custom documentations can even take effect before the arrival of the vessel.
I see. So you don't have to wait for the vessel to come and get to know that your container is in Ghana before you start your processes?
Not at all. You can immediately start import, or you even take a decision to import. You can even start processing your custom documentations. And within 3 days, you can even clear your container if you have processed all your documents. But most of our customers, most of our consignees, most of the shippers will not do that. They will wait for the container to arrive, the cargo to arrive in their country before they start the process. I have imported a vehicle before. Immediately I took the decision, I went through the processes. When the vehicle was put in a container and I had a container number and I knew the vessel, before the vessel even arrived in Ghana, I called my agent and we went through the processes. So when the vessel arrived, I did not even pay any money as demurrage to shipping line. I didn't pay any money as rent to GPHA. Somebody will say that because I have the privilege of knowing when the vessel has arrived. It is not so. The advice came from the shipping line that, interestingly, with current trends, with modern trends, you can even track the
vessel,
where the vessel is at any given time. The facilities are there to
and
track.
And even on the GPHA website, one is able to identify where the vessels are.
I
have seen on the GPHA
website.
It is there. So folks can be able to track where vessels are, and it enables you to know and plan well.
And plan well. On daily basis, when you go to our website, you can see expected vessels, you can see vessels at the anchorage, you can see the vessels in port, and the expected vessels, the dates of arrivals, they are all indicated on our website. So when you go to that open our website, you can see all the information that you want, and then you can easily track your vessel, when the vessel will come in, when the vessel has completed cargo work, where the container will even go, you will know. What we are doing now, we are taking advantage of modern technology to even advise consignees that your container is at Golden Jubilee, your container is at TCT.
Also, this program brings you the vessels that are in port at this particular time as I speak to you, vessels that are also at the anchorage as at this time as I speak to you, and vessels that are expected for this entire week from Monday to Sunday. And that's what you should be seeing on your screens very shortly.
We have also realized that our bulk cargo traffic is improving very fast. Formerly, we have only Gassem handling dry bulk cargo in this port. Now, we have three other cement companies around here. A fourth one is being established. So, you can see that the one bed facility that we have for dry bulk cargo, particularly this dirty cargo, is not enough to handle four vessels at the same time. And because of that, we have invested $122 million in a dry bulk jetty. Now, the jetty is about 65% complete, and by the end of this year, that jetty will be completed fully, and we can well receive four dry bulk cargo vessels at the same time. Wow. And work them at the same time. We realize we cannot continue dredging the old facility. If you continue dredging, it may collapse. Technically, it's not advisable. So going into the future, we plan to expand our ports westward towards Akumono. That expansion work is going to cost us over $1.5 billion. How? We want to expand the port to be as much as three times the existing facility. And that job is supposed to start this year. By the third quarter of this year, Ghanaians will see signs. You know, GPHA is part of MPS. That's one. I want to make it clear to all Ghanaians that GPHA is part of MPS. GPHA is a shareholder in MPS. So MPS is not a foreign company as such. It is a collaboration or a joint venture between GPHA and Maesline and Bolloré. And because we are part of the deal, we need to come up with a new concession agreement.
Okay.
And the new concession agreement, we have to put final touches to it. Okay. And within the next 2 or 3 months, all these ifs and I's and then the Y's and then the comments will also be sorted out. And then we can go ahead and then sign the agreement. When the agreement is signed, or the concession agreement is signed between GPHA on one side and MPS, which is GPHA's baby,
yeah,
on the other side, we would then go ahead and start the development project.
Can you tell us a bit about what goes into the port expansion proper? What are we to see?
Yeah, with the port expansion, we realize that we cannot have the port without proper road network or rail network access routes in and out of the port. And because of that, MPS found it very necessary to add a package to the port expansion agreement we signed. And the package is to expand the motorway to 6 lanes, 3 at each side. And it will also come up with an express road into the port.
Wow.
An express road at the abattoir area. Mm-hmm. It will be with an overpass or an interchange. An interchange at the abattoir with an express road into the port. And it will also take advantage, it will also take advantage to build an interchange at the terminal end of the motorway.
So why haven't we done all of these in the past? Why now? What changed?
What changed is management.
Okay.
The style of management has changed.
Okay.
And like I said, this current management of GPHA,
yeah,
is not a talking type of management. It's a doing type of. We want all the things that people have talked about in the past, we want to just translate them.
We want it to be done.
Yes, we want this translated into proper action. We want people to see it. We want people to feel it that, oh, GPHA is now taking the country to a different level, and not that, oh, we will do it, we will do it. No, no, we don't want to be saying that we will do it. We want it done. We want it done.
Well, folks, that was the director of the Port of Tema, Jacob Adoko, assuring all of us that the congestion problem and most of the frustration faced at the Port of Tema has reduced drastically. As the director of Port talked about the expansion works, a couple of weeks ago, the CEO of Maersk Worldwide was in Ghana, and Maersk is a partner of the company MPS that's supposed to construct the $1.5 billion port expansion. So I put the question to him whether the funding arrangement is all in place for the port expansion work. Let's listen to what he had to say.
The funding arrangement for the $1.5 billion port project, how is that going?
Well, it's for our part, we of course are a very strong business group, so we don't have any funding issues normally. So we don't see any problems there, and we will talk with our partners to make sure that everybody come up with the financing. All that is going on, so when we sign the concession agreement, that the project will be secured.
Iron Port returns pretty shortly.
UT Logistics have come to stay. When you approach a job like the way we approach it, each job is unique. Each client is unique. We provide the best service in the system. We have best staff. We are very fast. We are quick, and we save customers a lot of money.
I'll take care of you. All it takes is letting go. Let you down. I'll always be by your side. It's only when you do that you truly win. Wipe away your tears. I'll be your best friend. That's when you experience the magic of each moment. Like it's the first time. All it takes is letting go. A great man once said, "The world is won by those who let go." At Star Assurance, we take care of the things you care about so you're free to be all you can be. Let go and let Star. Talk to us today. Star Assurance, your solid partner.
Next up are some activities and news items that have been taking place within the port enclave of Ghana.
The supply of electricity to industrial and commercial customers within the ports and free zones enclave in Tema is expected to receive a boost with the inauguration of the Enclave Power Company, EPC, Ghana's first private electricity distribution substation. EPC for now purchases electricity from Volta River Authority and distributes to customers within the Free Zones enclave.
When completed, this project will complement the Tema Port expansion and create the capacity to handle the projected increase in exports and imports to Ghana and the landlocked countries beyond. It will enhance the development of the transport on the Volta Lake.
At the inauguration ceremony, the Minister of Power, Dr. Kabna Donkor, encouraged investors to invest in the power sector. The President, John Mahama, also reiterated his government's commitment to addressing the power gap in the Ghanaian economy. Meanwhile, the representative of Hyflex Company, one of the largest power and energy company in the world in terms of ownership based in Singapore, has also shown interest to provide electric power to the port community as well as treated water to vessels for the port of Tema. The company was part of a business delegation led by the Ambassador of Singapore to the Ghana Ports and Harbours Authority with the expectation of investing in the port activities.
Because of water, we need power. So that's why we also go into power. So we have actually owned and built our 411 megawatt combined cycle gas turbine power plant in Singapore, 100% owned by us. So that is actually done by us as well.
The visit was also aimed at strengthening the ties between Singapore and Ghana and the ports of the two countries. The Singaporean ambassador stated that several companies in Singapore have expressed keen interest to invest in Ghana's ports. A Singaporean IT company with focus on e-government solution also expressed interest in the IT sector of the port's operations. The Director General of GPHA, flanked by his management team, seized the opportunity to highlight the immense contribution the planned port expansion will bring to the nation.
And the government is working on reinstating the rail from Takoradi to the hinterland.
Inside, up north.
Yeah.
I see. Okay.
And that might be shorter. But it will be shorter
than from
here
to the north. Huh?
So you could end up attracting
more vessels
to that area, and especially the transit trades.
The Ship Owners and Agents Association, SOAG, has launched a campaign against the stealing and illegal sale of containers. SOAG hopes to use the campaign to reduce and, if possible, curb the incident of container theft by appealing to the general public to double-check with the association on containers they intend to buy using its hotline 057-196-2712.
Our problem is those who fraudulently, you know, through several schemes they put in place to get access to containers purportedly for export. You know, they come up with all sorts of tricks to get access to containers, and then they don't return the containers. This export never comes on. Now that they have access to the containers, then they try to sell it on to innocent people who are not aware that the source is not a genuine source.
The use of containers in carrying cargo was introduced into the maritime industry in the 1930s to make shipment of goods less cumbersome and reduce damages and pilfering of consignment with cheaper handling and claim cost. SOAG is therefore appealing to stakeholders who mistakenly keep containers after discharging their goods and those who deliberately steal them to desist from such acts.
Obviously, if you find yourself buying a stolen container, you would lose it. It's like you throw money away. So basically, this is to educate the public.
Some port users are expressing anger and disappointment about the poor road network within the port enclave. According to the port users, the roads in front of the Golden Jubilee Terminal, CTC and Hallblythe Road has almost become unmotorable, hence posing great challenge on their day-to-day activities. They lament the dust that is also generated by the poor road network is becoming unbearable, hence pleaded to the port authority to fix the road.
This road has been there for a very, very long time. And we can't tell why a government, I mean, terminal of this house cannot do this road.
But road, if sometimes we load and it's like the staff is heavy small, I mean, because of the road is rough, you will find it difficult before you enter into the main road. And if you see the distance of the road, it's just short. And I mean, we have a few people when people help us and let the people, I mean, do the road for us.
We're going away at that hall no more than 10 to 12 years. I mean, we started our harbor hard. But because of Hallbright, Safe Bond, TCT, some couple women now, you don't get me contributing now. I'm with Cal Road, Miss Wa, a coin, a baby. Now, so be a depending Gapua. And a Gapua, so it's also a muffin trailers, no end town far road, Miss Unentino. Almost no. Omo show concern some beye ekwano. Now so say traffic pass super. No more the lockers. Aba be locking trailers.
However, the director of the port of Tema, Jacob Adoko, is assuring all port users that the construction of those routes will commence this year, as they have all been captured in the 2015 budget.
The road in front of DCT GJT, it is in our budget for this year. If you realize, we have already started constructing the road between ACS and the Meridian, the beach route from ACS to the Meridian Junction. We are going to put the one in front of TCT to the Meridian Junction also on tender very soon.
He assured port users that the challenges posed by the poor road network will soon be a thing of the past.
I'll take care of you. All it takes is letting go.
Let you down. I'll always be by your side.
It's only when you do that you truly win.
Wipe away your tears. I'll be your best friend.
That's when you experience the magic of each moment.
Starship.
like it's the first time. All it takes is letting go. A great man once said, the world is won by those who let go. At Star Assurance, we take care of the things you care about so you are free to be all you can be. Let go and let Star. Talk to us today. Star Assurance, your solid partner.
We are very transparent as well, and we approach every job with professionalism and the seriousness that it requires. For us, every job is different, and our approach is different. We take our time to understand our customers, and we ensure that what our customers need is what we deliver. And that is why UT Logistics is now all over the place.
Kenel Batabana is a port security manager and here to help us with security tips.
The port is an operational area, and as such, we have in place heavy machinery whose operation can be dangerous to human life. Consequently, we recommend that at all times, any person within the port operational area should be in a reflective jacket, should wear safety boots, or at least footwear that cover one's toes. This is very important because in the case of an accident, one may be entitled to insurance. And for your own good and for the orderliness of the port and the status we want to maintain in our ISPS compliance, that when entering the port, please remember to wear your reflective jacket and safety footwear.
Coming up next is a schedule of vessels that are at the anchorage, as well as those that are already in the port and those that are expected for the entire week. So if you're expecting any of those vessels in the coming week, those are very vital information for you. Also, that's it for this edition of Eye on Ports, and I hope that I have been able to bring the activities of the ports of Ghana closer to you, and also you closer to the ports of Ghana. I hope you don't miss another edition of Eye on Ports same time next week on this same platform, because I'm likely to take you on board that vessel or even be lifting that container for you. My appreciation goes to my entire crew, Robert Nyantechi, as well as Joe Lavo and the rest of the team. The program is brought to you by kind courtesy of UT Logistics. UT Logistics, they offer you customized solution as well as Star Assurance. Star Assurance is always your solid partner. Never ever miss them for any other insurance company, because Star Assurance is your solid partner. Thank you for watching.